In our guru, row selection can be performed by selecting a sequence of rows or by using logical expressions. For this tutorial, I'm going to be using the student survey dataset from the Our Guru User's Guide repository. If you need assistance loading this dataset, please reference our video, Uploading a Dataset from an Our Guru repository. From the Data toolbar, click on the Functions menu, then scroll down to Subset. Within the dataset dropdown, select Student Survey. In the Row Selection box, you will see the Logical Expression button. If you are interested in creating subsets using sequences, we encourage you to reference our video, Subsetting Data by Row and Column Selection. Once you click on the Logical Expression button, you will see another dialog box open. By hitting the green plus button, a line will be added to the Logical Expression Creator List box. The Variable dropdown consists of all the variable names in the selected dataset. The OP dropdown, which stands for Operation, is where you can choose between the operations Equal, Not Equal, Greater Than or Equal To, Less Than or Equal To, Strictly Greater Than, or Strictly Less Than. The Values Combo box allows you to fill in this box in two ways. If you have selected a numerical variable, you can type in values, or you can select another numerical variable from the Value dropdown. For example, if I choose hours of TV, I can simply type in the number 8, or compare hours of TV to hours of sleep by selecting that variable. Let me go through a specific example and show you how this process works with both a numeric and categorical variable. Let's start by selecting the fast MPH variable for expression E3. This variable recorded the fastest speed a student has ever driven. I'm then going to select the strictly greater than operation. And to finish this expression, I'm going to type in the value 100. This logical expression has now asked for all the cases where a student has driven faster than 100 miles per hour. Hit the green plus button again, and this time select the sex variable for expression E6. I'm then going to select the equal operation, and this time, in the values combo box, we can now select one of the levels from our categorical variable within the dropdown. I'll finish the expression by selecting male. If you would like to remove a logical expression, click on the red X, and that specific expression will be removed. Or you can hit the broomstick and remove all logical expressions. Now, when there is more than one logical expression in your list, you can use the down arrows in the column labeled Pick to drop each expression into the logical expression calculator. Here is where you can combine your expressions by using the operations parentheses, and, or, and not. So if I picked E6 only, this logical expression would only select the male students from our dataset. However, if I was to hit the AND button and also pick the E3 expression, this results in an expression that selects the male students who have driven faster than 100 miles per hour. Hitting the clear button will allow you to change the logical expression calculation criterion. And when you're all finished, click the Done button. Every logical expression constructed will be assigned a predefined name and include the definition names in the row subset list. You can repeat this process as many times as you wish and continue to add various row selections to your subset list. And just like within the logical expression dialog box, you can combine your subsets by using the operations intersect, minus, union, and union all in the set calculator at the bottom. On a final note, you can also re-edit any row subset you created by double-clicking on it. We are now ready to see our subset by hitting the preview icon. Here we can see that there were 11 male students from this dataset that have driven faster than 100 miles per hour. If you would like further details and examples on how to use the data subset function, please see the chapter, Data Manipulation of a Single Dataset, from our user guidebook.